This is the Finesse Media Podcast.
I didn't want to step that low. What you say, Sora? Step, step, so step and Sora. Step, step, Sora's on the way. Step, step, so step and Sora's with the soul. Step and Sora's up, a.k.a. Come on, step, step, so step and Sora's.
It's a whole month into the year. It's February, and I'm back with a new episode and a new guest. And each and every week on the Finesse Media Podcast, I tell you, I bring you something brand new. But this week, I got something brand new. But again, welcome back to Season 5 of the Finesse Media Podcast. Happy New Year to everybody. It's good to see you out there. And this week and this month and every week, we're going to be kicking things off Black History Month. But I thought to bring in some of the folks that I know that's a part of the Divine Nine organization, the National Panhellenic Council. Those members are going to be featured throughout the month. So kicking it off in the most finest way is a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. You know the sorority, but you're probably also familiar with the face. She's an actress. She's a host. She's a writer. I mean, she's a woman of many different talents and also a singer. Make some noise. Joining for the second time, she joined us in season one. Welcome back to the podcast, my girl Trina Braxton. What's up, girl?
I got my own little, there first.
Hey, Trina, you know I was so excited to see when you had became a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha.
Yes, I'm excited to be a part of this sisterhood. It's just absolutely amazing.
What made you choose Alpha Kappa Alpha? Because I was thinking, did she do honorary? But then no, you came through grad chapter.
And let me tell you this, first of all, there's nothing wrong with honorary. Because, you know, they give homage to these women in life who paid their dues, no matter what, you know, part of the Divine Nine or the Panhellenic they choose. But I will say this, a lot of people thought that I was going to choose Zeta Phi Beta.
Because you know, I was coming for it.
Yes, because, you know, I have two sisters, my sister, rest in peace, and in heaven, Tracy, who was Zeta, and my sister, Tawanda, who's Zeta Phi Beta. And she's also a Sigma Dove.
Okay. I didn't know that about Tawanda.
A lot of people thought that, you know, and we share a lot of history with the Zetas, S-A-K-A's, because they were January 16th, 1920 at Howard University.
Yeah.
And we were January 15th, you know, 1908, Howard University. But I had to do what was best for me.
Yeah.
And what resonated in my heart and in my life. And, you know, you have a lot of these youngsters coming up, oh, I want to be AKA, I like the colors, I like, you know, to shake my head, but that's not what the organization is about. Yeah. You need to do your homework and see which one is best for you, because there are other members and other sororities in the Divine Nine that are well worthy of anyone to choose. Mm-hmm. But for me, you know, with AKA being the first and the finest, you know, I have so many firsts in my life, and it only made sense for me to become a part of the first.
Yeah.
I'm the first girl in my whole family to graduate from college. I'm the first girl in my whole family to become, you know, an entrepreneur. I have just a lot of firsts in my life, and it just made a lot of sense.
Wow.
You know, and what they represent, you know, the service and the class and the excellence. And I can go on and on. So I know you're like, okay, Trina, I wasn't looking for this long of an answer.
No, but that's good, because I didn't know those things about you, Trina, about you being the first person to graduate from college, the first person to start.
The first female.
First female to graduate from college. And then, I mean, and then the business owner, shout out to Bar Chicks. I mean, you have certainly been finessing the game, which is why you also, in part, was a one that I wanted to choose as a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha, because not only a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha, you are definitely someone who's been finessing the game. And again, you're a friend to the show. But as you mentioned, a first of a whole toolage, a village of sisters. And that's sisterhood. And we've seen it. We won't even get into that. But the sisterhood with a sorority is a little bit different. What do you love most about your sisterhood with AKA Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated?
Yes. And before I go on, I will say that I also belong to the first chapter of AKA in Atlanta, Georgia, Kappa Omega. Just thought I'd put that out there.
Just continuing to check the box of many firsts. That's
what's up. I put that out there. I grew up with a lot of female family members. So I am used to what people would deem a sisterhood. And while I love each and every one of my sisters collectively and individually, sometimes the family that you create for yourself can sometimes be closer than the family that you were born into.
Yeah.
And this sisterhood as a part of, you know, Alpha Kappa Alpha Incorporated, you know, it's just, it's a different kind of sisterhood because I get to belong to people outside of the Braxton family, and they get to know me as an individual and what I can bring to the organization, as opposed to what everybody knows I can bring to the sisterhood that I have with the Braxtons. So it brings something different elementally as a part of the sisterhood. And it's been one of the most fulfilling experiences I've ever had in my life.
Yeah. And we know, of course, Vice President Kamala Harris. I mean, not only just a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha, but as we roll and continue to roll out this month of Black Excellence, an HBCU alumni, which I'm a very proud member of as well. So it's not just the Divine Nine, I think, that speaks so much of to the soul of the sisterhood and connection. But if you went to an HBCU, shout out to my HBCUs out there that continue to
support. Yes, Bowie State University, BSU.
That's what I'm saying. And so it's an HBCU time. And so being a part of a sisterhood and having that connection, you know, along with that is truly amazing. But when you're in a sisterhood, of course, I mean, you are sometimes trying to get your voices heard by doing chants, and that's a good time, right? What's one of your favorite chants, Trina? I know, again, you're still 30 seconds. You're a Neo.
Yeah, well, technically, but, you know, this is year three, so I'm sliding out of that. So
this year one, you're almost 1 year, right?
No, I'm over a year.
Oh, you are. When did you come through? Let's get that information.
I came through June 2021.
June 2020.
I was supposed to be in June 2020, but the pandemic happened.
Okay. Gotcha.
And, you know, AKA business is AKA business. So I'm going to leave that right there.
There you go. And what is the name now? Because we're at that space, and I am going to get back to the question about the chant, but you came through June 2021. How many ladies was it?
There were 124 ladies.
On your line, Trina?
Well, yeah, I'm number 17.
17. That was my follow up. Okay, I'm number 19, so we're somewhere close by.
Yeah, number 17.
Okay. But what's the favorite chant so far in being in the sorority? What has been your favorite chant to recite?
Well, there are so many amazing chants. I'm just going to put that out there. But my favorite chant, I've kind of adopted it to one of my mantras for my daily life.
Okay.
And my favorite chant is, "This is a serious matter." Yes. Because it is. Everything you do in life is a serious matter. So you can apply it to your everyday. And that's what I do.
Yeah. No, definitely. And you know, that's so catchy, because I do say that to a lot of my sister Greeks, you know, friends of Alpha Kappa Alpha. I'll go, you know, it's a serious matter. You know, it's a serious matter. And they know immediately.
Even choosing what, you know, part of the Divine Nine you're going to belong to, because it's lifelong.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, it's a serious matter. You have to do what's in your heart, not what other people believe you should be doing. Like, because everybody's like, why didn't you choose that? Why didn't you say? Because I have my own personal reasons.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, would it have made sense? Yes.
Yeah.
But I had to do where my servitude would allow me to be a better person.
Mm-hmm. And Trina, with you being a part of Alpha Kappa Alpha, there are so many different people. Shout out to Rashawn Ali. That's just one that comes to mind. She's a rattler. She sits on the highest of seven heels. What's up, Rashawn? But I mean, listen, there's so many dynamic people within the organization of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority. And again, you are someone who's been finessing the game for a very long time, Trina. But who's that person for you within your organization of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated that you say that's finessing the game? And you can't
say there are so many amazing members. You talk about Kamala, we even have these amazing honorary members, Felicia Rashawn, Auntie Patty LaBelle.
Shout out to Patty LaBelle. I was going to get that, man. How you get Patty LaBelle?
Campbell. We have Kiki Palmer. You know,
Erica Campbell. Yeah.
Of amazing honorary members. But the person for me, and you keep taking my answers, who's finessing the game, is Rashawn Ali.
Yes.
I mean, everyone doesn't know.
I be feeling like the man when I walk through. Hang stunning what you're saying when I walk through. I got all these people staring when I walk through. I done made a few bands on the walk through.
Watch me,
hey, watch me walk through.
Watch me,
hey, watch me walk through.
Watch me,
hey, watch me walk through. I done made a few bands on the walk through.
About her hustle, and people look like from the outside that she made it overnight, but it took her 20 years to make it overnight.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Shout out to the Cool Soror podcast, by the way.
Yeah, shout out to Cool Soror. You know, she hustled a lot in the game. You know what I mean? She started off, you know, journalist from FAMU, and you know, she was doing a lot of, you know, things for the Falcons, and you know, starting on her journalist journey, and then we were together on a talk show.
Yeah. Shout out to Sister Circle.
Yes. But everyone in the game should know who Rashan Ali is. You know, from her hustle from the beginning. And now she has her amazing podcast, Cool Soror. She has, she's on 2 Tyler Perry shows.
Yeah.
I mean, she's raising 2 amazing children. She's married. She is, you know, she's what, 26 years now?
Yeah.
In the AKA. Yes.
And doesn't look a day over 21, by the way.
Does not.
She's working out so much. I mean, like, between her and our other good friend, Cherie, I'm like, would y'all sit down somewhere?
Cherie's a Zana, but we're going to leave that where it is.
But I'm just saying, they work out so much.
I'm
just saying, they work out so much, though, Trina.
Well, you know what?
They always in the gym.
They both stay ready so they don't have to get ready.
Yeah.
And that's what I love about them.
Yeah.
And I have nothing but admiration and praise for them. And at first, Rashan and I, she's just like, okay, Trina, you're giving me good advice. You're giving me some great nuggets, you know that. And now I'm looking to her.
Yeah.
You know, I'm like, Rashan, I'm like, what's up? What's going on, sis? Like,
she is dope.
She's absolutely amazing. And on top of it all, she's the most grounded, the most down-to-earth person I've ever met in my entire life. Because she knows the struggle.
Yeah, yeah. And she's such a sweet Cancer, too, by the way. Her and my wife share the same birthday. I mean, she's a sweet, soft, pink, lovable Cancer. She is really nurturing, though. You know, she's tough. Don't take it lightly.
She's a tough
lady. But I love the fact that she is persistent, resilient, and a lady just not going to let grass grow underneath her feet. She just continues to move. Yeah, I got to get on this podcast. Rashan got to come over here, and I got to get over to the Cool Soror. I mean, she got to probably make it a Fred edition.
You do well. And she has an amazing nonprofit for girls in sports. It's just amazing. Sporty. It's called Sporty Girl.
Mm-hmm.
So if anybody wants to look it up, Sporty Girl Inc., that's her nonprofit. She is just that chick.
Yeah.
She is that chick.
And Trina, when you say that Rashan stays ready so that she doesn't have to get ready, that's kind of the segue into my next question. So I hope you're ready. Because what I also do each and every week on the Finesse Media podcast, even though this whole month long it's a Divine 9 edition, I am still keeping that cadence where I'm peeking into your social media and I'm finding pictures or videos or maybe a statement that you made on your social media platform, and I'm bringing it to the podcast and in this conversation, and I want you to tell me, what was this photo or what was this video about? Are you ready? Because if you stay ready, you got to get ready.
That's the question. Are you?
Am I ready? I am. Let me pull this photo up that I found on your social media platform, and you tell me what this photo was about.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here we go.
Oh! My husband and I went to St. Lucia.
It looked like a good time. I'm a foodie, so I immediately got attracted by the food.
Well, I'm a foodie too, and I'm a cookie.
Okay.
I love to cook.
What were y'all? What was this?
We were in St. Lucia at Calle Blanc Villas.
Okay.
And it was one of the most amazing times we've had. We've only been married for 3 years. We've been together for 5 years, but married for 3. You know, this is my 3rd marriage, so 3 times is a charm.
Shout out to Vaughn. Shout out to Vaughn.
Shout out to my love, Vaughn Scales. Hey, baby. It was so great and it's so amazing. And I don't like to post erroneous things on my social media. Mm-hmm. And you'll notice sometimes there are huge gaps where I'm like, okay, I really need to hire you. I really do, because you know, sometimes it just lays dormant for a second. But it has to make sense for me. And lately I've been posting reels about things that people don't really see as, you know, palatable for them,
mm-hmm.
but I don't care. because I think when you see something, you say something. Mm-hmm. And if you don't say something, then you're complicit. And I don't believe in complicity. And if I see something, I'm going to say something. And I'm about to be really, really in a place where people are not going to like me. But I don't like the state of the world today.
Okay. Okay. So this is a new project. It's something we're going to be seeing soon.
It's not necessarily a project because I'm still working on the betterment of the things I'm already working on. And I think when you have too many hands in one pot, something's going to go wrong with it. It's going to get burnt or you're not watching it close enough. But I am going to say this. There are some things that I feel really strongly about that I am going to start saying things about. And it's not necessarily going to be the public opinion.
Okay. Well, I think
I don't agree with all this. With the digital currency, I don't agree with it.
Okay. Okay. So what is it called? I don't know. I don't get involved in it either. So clearly I'm having a brain fart, but there's a lot of cryptocurrency, I guess. Is that what you're saying?
No, this is beyond cryptocurrency. This is digital currency and it's moving toward, you know, the one world, you know, financial system, you know, because now you can walk into a store. They have these new grocery stores where you just walk in, you get a QR code, you get what you need to get, and then you just walk out.
I saw that in the airports. It's like that. They have like a store in the airport where you just kind of walk in and grab your iPod and then you just walk out. And I'm like, who is going to pay for this? They're like, we charged you already. I'm like, whoa.
Yeah. You'll get a receipt.
Yeah.
And I think if it's not something that we are for, then we take the power away. Because if you're quiet, then you're complicit. Yeah. So.
It is. Okay, well, I will look forward to it. But I think, Trina, we expect that from you, right? From your hand gesture, from your pop music, Party or Go Home. You know, I was listening to that before we started. I said, let me go back and listen to Party or Go Home. And I must be honest and be very transparent when I say, I didn't know about Game Time. First off, I thought Game Time was before, the beehives don't come after me. But that introduction sounded a lot like what we heard Beyonce do on the Netflix special with the Homecoming. You had the band and the whole, and you know I'm a band guy, HBCU, March the band, the whole bit. The band, the instrumentals. I said, wait, how did this get past me? I missed that track. Trina, I missed that single, but I heard it today.
I'm going to revamp it, actually. I would love for it to be something that the NBA, WNBA, NFL stands for when it's time for games. It's game time.
Yeah. So. Pitch it to an HBCU. I mean, really, I think it being played on the field, doing a halftime show, and Trina's out there, you know, dipping in and doing it, because you're not young, Trina.
I beg your pardon.
I said, you're not young, Trina. I still
That's what I said. I beg your pardon. Your baby daddy's not young.
Trina Braxton joined the podcast again for the second time. We're in season 5, and you came on in season 1 when I started this whole thing.
Wait, I'm still holding on to the fact that you said that I'm not young. You know what?
Well, I meant you're not old. I did say that, and I said it twice. I said, Trina, you're not young. I meant, Trina, you're not old. And I wonder why that rebuttal was coming. My wording was completely wrong. My apologies. And I'm not even going to edit that out.
And you said what you said.
No, you're not. You're not old, Trina. So you can get out there with those major reds. And listen, Listen, we could work something out with my university, University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff. The homecoming at HBCU is popping. You all will come down there and have the band to play your song and you get out there with the Golden Girls.
But guess what? I'm here for the Golden Girls. And let me tell you something. If I haven't lived some, then I don't have any advice to give to these young people.
That's right.
So it is because of the experiences that I have had and that have occurred in my life that I can give some advice or I can give, you know, a good speech. I could give a good talking to, you know, to that next generation coming up. Because if I haven't lived, then what can I give?
Yeah, for sure. Well, you can give me another episode and maybe you need to come back and hang out with me and co-host or something.
For sure. I mean, as long as I'm still around to do it, then my old
And Trina, you know I see this pink and green down there. Are you wearing Alpha Kappa Alpha over there? There she is. January the 15th, happy belated Founders Day.
Thank you very much.
And she's wearing her pearls. She's a pretty girl. Pretty girls wear 20 pearls. Is that what it is?
Yes, they do. But guess what? Any girl is pretty. She can always wear her pearls if she chooses to.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Kicking things off the first and finest way is my girl Trina Braxton joining me again on the Finesse Media Podcast. Trina, let people know how they can I know how they know they can follow you, but still, it's probably some new people. Let them know how they can keep up with you, or what do you want the people to know, or what's coming up?
Oh, wow. You can find out everything Trina Braxton on TrinaBraxton.com, but Instagram, Trina Braxton 1. Facebook is Trina Braxton. The only thing that I want people to know about me is that I'm always on my hustle. I'm always on my grind. And if you ever need advice, you can always DM me, because someone helped me. So I'm here to help that next person.
Yeah, that's a lot to say from someone who really, when you think about the level of success that you and your sisters have had, and you're saying, hey, I'm still willing to learn and to help someone else. I think that speaks again to the character of someone that say, I can help someone that doesn't owe me anything. Yeah, that says a lot about your character. Yeah. So you've been 100, Trina, ever since I've known you. And continue this whole situation and the journey that you have. Again, come back on, hang out with me on the podcast. And again, enjoy the rest of the Black History Month that we about to enjoy for the next coming weeks. They give us 28 days. We got like 30 seconds left.
Okay, well, I'm going to tell you, I would love to come back on so we can talk about this homage to Dr. Martin Luther King and his wife.
Did you see it? What did you think about that? You liked it?
I don't understand it.
Okay. You don't understand. It needs interpretation. I think they should have maybe the picture next to it so that when tourists walk up, they can go, oh, that's what this is.
Yes.
And it's not a man giving all pleasures is what I heard somebody say it looks like.
I'm honest that I did see something that looked a little sexually ambiguous.
Yeah.
But I'm going to leave that where it is for now. You only have to have me back. You only have about, 10 seconds now at this point?
How about that? Right?
Like, all right, Trina. How about that?
Well, guys, you've been watching another episode of the Finesse Media Podcast, Season 5. I'm your host, Ken Finesse Media, and I'll see you next week with something brand new. Peace. All right, we'll do that. There you go.
Yes! Always a...
Podcast. Join us again next week for the latest news from HBCUs. Special guest.